Well, I don't think you're going to find a board any more colourful than this on the market. This is the Starboard GO in the Starshot Sun construction. You might recognise the graphics from the last review we did, which was the inflatable 11.2 Tikhine, and that was done in the wave graphics, the blue graphics. Remember, these graphics and artwork have been done by Starboard team rider Sonny Honscheid, great racer, great paddleboarder, and a fantastic artist. So get this, people, this is not an inflatable, this is a hardboard. This is the first hardboard of 10.8 by 31 or any sort of all-round size that we reviewed this year. Goes to show how popular inflatable paddleboards are at the moment, but you've got to hear this review out before you buy yourself an ISUP, because this board might just tick the boxes instead of those ISUPs. So specifications for this board, it's 10'8" long, it's 31 inches wide, it's 4.5 inches thick, brings the literage in at 192 litres. It comes as standard with a 9-inch single US box fin. It weighs 11.4 kilograms and it retails at £1,199. So this is the Starboard GO in the Starshot construction with the Sun graphic. You can also get this board with the Wave graphic and the Dot graphic as well. And construction wise, bear with me here, you can also buy this board in an ASAP, much harder wearing. It's got soft rails, got full deck grip right over the whole board. Great for learning, also maybe great for schools or people getting into the sport, can take a lot of punishment. And then you can move up from there. They do a Star Light construction, which again is a bit more hard wearing than this board, comes with the carbon Inegra rails, which you might have seen on other boards we reviewed, like the wide points and stuff we've done a few months ago. Really hard wearing rail system. That board's actually a little bit heavier than this board, so it's not as light, but it's much tougher. If you want to go for a lighter base board, you can get the Sun carbon top, which looks like this, way lighter. It's only just over 10 kilograms, I think. It's a bit more money. Again, it's £1,399, but if you're after a lighter weight board with the same style and graphics as this, that could be the board to look at. Otherwise, other sizes these boards are available in. So this is the 10.8, this sort of sits in the middle of the range. You can get a 9.4 by 28, a 10.2 by 29, an 11.2 by 32, and an 11.6 by 33. That board obviously offering the most stability. So that's a bit of information about the other GO boards you can get. The constructions of this board, the GO Starshot has got an EPS internal core, multiple layers of glass wrapped around the board. Under the deck standing area, there's a veneer, wooden veneer of pine. This gives it much more reinforcing. Really like the fact that the board comes as standard with scratch resistant rail tape along the side of the board. Looks very good and it's really well stuck. And there it stops the abrasion, stops the impact from you and your paddle strokes down the side of the board. So there's all your specifications and numbers about the board. Let's get on about what this board looks like and what it is like on the water. Well, first off, wow, it is an incredibly good looking board. Thought the ISUP we tested a couple weeks ago looked good, but this on a hardboard, the graphics just really stand out and really come out well. So this is the Sun graphic from Sony. Remember, you can also get this board in the Wave edition as well, which is the blue version. I really can't go on enough how good this board looks in the flesh. In the catalogues, it looks pretty cool when we saw it earlier in the year, but to be honest, it really in the flesh, it really does stand out. And what also stands out, and I suppose it's not really a surprise, is the finish of the Starboard board. Just the way that the graphics is all cut around, bungee points at the front of the board here and down the rails, and how the deck pad sort of fits just on the board. Everything just looks really, really good. And I sort of surprise myself when we unpack Starboard boards, and boards of all levels, of all brands, are all really good at the moment. But the Starboard stuff is just really, really up there with quality. So other stuff you've got to note, you've got your FCS mount at the front there for your maybe your GoPro or action camera, bungee straps for carrying stuff, great flip-flops, bits and pieces like this. This area up here is not waxed, or there's no deck grip here, so if you do want to do yoga maneuvers and you come further up towards the board, you might have to put a bit of wax or some sort of deck gripping on that area. Just something to note if you are unsure if it has or hasn't. But the deck pad does start quite far forward. The deck grip's finished off with a crocodile skin pattern over the deck, and it is incredibly grippy on your feet. So if you are going to get into yoga moves or stretching or just general paddle fitness, this sort of deck pad is going to give you enough security so your feet aren't going to slip. at this point, I'm also going to mention about how flat the deck is as well. The board's incredibly flat, from obviously from the deck pad right across to the other side and pretty much all the way back to the tail, just offers you that massive flat area. If you have an arch or a dome on the board, any sort of footwork or moving around the board or stretching or yoga poses you might be doing on the board, it will be harder to do. Having a flat deck on the board just makes it way easier for you to use and move around. Other things that are worth talking about: big carry handle, recessed, very easy to use, and the shoulder strap, the bungee shoulder strap, carry strap, that can stay on the board all the time if you want, or you can take it off the board as well. But I really see no need to take it off the board. It doesn't get in the way and it pings back and it sits really comfortably on there. Exactly the same bungee strap that came with the inflatable we tested. Liked it on that board, like it on this board as well. So I know we've already said about it, but the rail tape that comes as standard on the board also comes with all the Starshot boards. Such a simple thing to have on the board, but it's so nice that it comes as standard and it really makes a difference to keeping your board in tip-top condition. So let's have a look at the overall shape and design of this board and then talk about a bit of performance. So the overall shape, it's nothing extraordinary overall shape, a nice outline profile, slender, pulled in slightly towards the back of the tail and a nice round nose. Obviously the board, the outline shape of the board is going to offer you a large stable platform, as we said, big flat deck pad, but also being 31 wide gives you that good stable width either side of your feet. The outline shape makes it nice and easy to paddle in a straight line and you offer you a good amount of glide because of its length, being 10 foot 8 long. But really this board deserves way more credit than just a few words of how well it goes in a straight line. They have put a lot into this board and we feel personally that a lot of the R&D that they've put into their award-winning race boards and their fantastic touring boards, they've put into this GO board as well. So you've got a big dugout chime or channel concave in the middle of the board. Now what that's going to do is forces the water into the middle of the board and back towards the fin, and also it actually lowers the board in the water. Now what that actually does is that increases your overall waterline length and then makes it easier to paddle. So actually makes sure that you've got your full board in the water, gives you more glide and more tracking. So there we go, that's a bit more why it's easy to paddle in a straight line and why it gives you a large amount of glide. But then also because of the sides here, this is where the stability of the board really gets ramped up compared to a normal flat bottom board. Like we said in the race boards, when you wobble the board from side to side, these side planes start to hit the water and force the water around the board, or try and stop the water from being forced around the board. Gives you more stability. Again, if you wanted to do some fitness, some yoga, that's the sort of thing you want on the board. And another really neat thing, which you only ever see on race boards generally, is the rail shapes of the board. They've actually brought them out and made them a bit boxier, so they made them squarer. So what that means for the average paddler doing all-round paddling is that less water is able to wrap around the rail of the board as you're rocking back off side to side, or you get a bump which comes towards you. And then that way it keeps the board more stable and out the water more. So this board is designed for pretty much everything. Bit of cruising, bit of fitness, bit of yoga, going down the river, but generally straight line, easy gliding. Now what Starboard have done with this is so simple, but not other any brand we've seen of this board type they have done it on. They have moved the fin box back slightly on this board. It is such a simple thing to do in the manufacturing process, makes a massive difference to when you're paddling. The further back the fin box is on the board, the straighter line your board is going to go. And it's the same with your fin. If you put your fin further back, the straighter the line your board is going to go in. So by them giving you the opportunity to move your fin right to the back of the board and go in that straighter line even easier, it's just a great thing to have. Again, with the channel in the center of the board and the fin box at the back, this board is the easiest paddling straight line board of 10 foot 8 we have ever paddled. Also couple that with the fin that they put on, which is a 9-inch cutaway fin, very swept back again, forcing all of that fin area as back as far as possible, just helps the tracking again in a straight line. So you get where they're coming from with this board. Easy to paddle in a straight line, great for cruising, gliding, and general all-round paddling fun. So do we think this board's best suited for? Well, we agree with Starboard. They recommend a 55 kilogram to 110 kg rider. Definitely going to suit that fine. It's going to give you a lot of stability. If you want more stability or more glide as well, look towards the bigger, longer boards. And again, if you're smaller, maybe if you're the 50 kg, 55, 60 kg, you could be looking at the smaller boards. But if remember, if you want to go in more straight line with more glide, don't always go smaller, maybe stick to rounds, the longer overall length boards. Okay, just because this board is pink doesn't mean a guy won't enjoy it. It's available in lots of different colors, and for the board itself, the shape and design, it's very nice to paddle. Incredibly easy. I can't get across how easy this board is to paddle. Straight line, cruising. I know they're going to keep this board running for 2019 range, so we are going to see this again next year. So don't worry, this is not just current for 2018. This is going to come into 2019 for sure. This has definitely been one of Starboard's most popular boards. And if you're looking for a mid-sized board like this, no doubt you've probably thought about buying an ISUP, or you already might be pretty much convinced on getting an ISUP. But let me tell you now, comparing this board to an ISUP, there is a completely different feel in the water. Hard boards are way more responsive, they give you way more glide, and they're just easier to paddle in general. I was talking about it in a SUPboarder Pro video we did a few weeks back about how hard boards, you can put more design into them and rocker line shape. This is a prime example of what you can do with a hard board compared to an inflatable. So if you can store it and if you can transport it to the beach, this is a very, very good all-round board that guys and girls should be looking at. To finish off with pros and cons and value for money, well, pros, yeah, you probably sense the feeling that we really do like this board. It is a fantastic bit of kit. The design that's gone into this board, the R&D is amazing. So good to see this in a general all-round paddling shape. Great graphics, really well finished. And cons, value for money, well, you can definitely buy a cheaper hardboard than this on the market. At £1,199, it is not the cheapest for sure. But the amount of R&D, design, and brand credibility you get with this board, let alone the finish of this board, it is 100% worth the money. If you are after an all-round board and you have got that sort of money to spend, definitely looking at the Starboard GO range is something you are not going to be disappointed in. Well, Starboard definitely deserves some more top marks for us for this board. The pink as well, I really do like it. But if you want something a little bit more manly, you could look towards the wave color as well. Hope you found this SUPboard review helpful and interesting. Remember, subscribe to YouTube. Check out SUPboarder Mag for more information on SUP and other techniques and reviews. And if you're really hooked on SUP, check out SUPboarder Pro, where we just do more of the stuff you love. Until next time, we'll see you on SUPboarder or on YouTube. Thanks a lot.